Salary standardization law number 5, tranche number 2. Magkano ang sasahuri ng mga teachers for 2021? As in yung buong sasahuri nila kasama yung mga deductions. And magkano yung pinaka-take home pay nila? So if you want to know more about this, stay tuned and watch until the end of the video. So I'm done discussing and sharing to you kung paano magko-compute ng PhilHealth as well as yung GSIS, yung tax, and yung pag-ibig. So this time around, I will be sharing to you magkano ba ang magiging sahod ng mga public school teachers for 2021. It will still be under the Salary Standardization Law number 5, tranche number 2. Before I discuss that, so kung hindi ka pa nakasubscribe, just simply click the subscribe button on this portion and syempre, pa-hit na yung notification bell para updated ka sa mga latest uploads ko and pa-thumbs up for this video and pa-share na rin kung meron kang time. So, for today, what I have mentioned nga naman is, I'm going to share kung paano ba ako computein or magkano ba ang pinaka-take home. So, hindi ko na iisa-isa yung computation kasi I have discussed that already in my previous videos. So, for today, I'm giving you the exact amount, as in exact amount, na susweldohin ng bawat teachers natin. So, yung teachers natin ay merong tatlong ranking. So, we have the teacher 1, teacher 2, and teacher 3. For teacher 1, that will be salary grade 11 kasi sa public or sa government, we are subdivided into salary grades. So salary grade number 11, salary grade 12 for teacher 2, and salary grade 13 for teacher 3. So magkano ang sasahuri ng bawat teachers natin? So for teacher 1, on the Hinga lang ko ng konti. On the Salary Standardization Law number 5, tranche 2, ito yung ating pinaka nakalagay na amount. So I have searched on this one and the amount is 23,877. Yan yung pinaka basic salary niya. And less yung PhilHealth, less yung GSIS, less yung pag-ibig, less yung tax, the amount that our teacher 1 will be getting, less lahat ng deductions will be 21,204.42. Pero dahil meron kaming allowance sa 2,000 pesos, so papalo siya ng 23,200 pesos. So yun yung pinaka-take home na ating teacher 1. Then for our teacher 2, based on the SSL 5 tranche 2, it will be 26,052 pesos. So less ulit yung PhilHealth, GSIS, yung pag-ibig, and yung tax, that will be amounting to 22,859.06. Again, meron din siyang 2,000 allowance, which is yung pera natin. That will be 24,859 for teacher 2. Then for our teacher 3, which is I belong on this bracket, pero meron akong step increment, so mas mataas na ng konti dun sa step 1 na teacher 3. So that will be 28,276. Then less ulit yung mga usual deductions natin, yung mga non-taxable, that will be amounting to 24,550.97. Then plus 2,000 ulit, that will be 26,550.97. So yun yung mga salary ng mga teachers. Pero as we all know, most of us, so I myself is included, meron kaming mga loans, although medyo mataas pakinggan, pero pag kinompute natin yan and we get the daily salary of a teacher, medyo kukulangin pa rin sa basic necessities natin, especially kung merong family, may mga anak, may mga nag-aaral. So medyo maliit pa rin yan. That's why most of the teacher organization are urging and opting the government, yung mga congressmen and our senators to make a salary increase for us. Pero syempre may proseso yun. So hintayin natin kung matutupad yung mga pangako o yung mga binibigay nilang mga promises sa amin na magkakaroon kami ng salary hike. So ito ay lahat ay teacher 1 to teacher 3 na step 1 lang po ah. So if ever na kayo po ay nag-step increment na or nasa step 7 na kayo, step 8, just go back with the previous videos kung paano kumpitin yung PhilHealth, yung SSA, ay SSS tuloy, yung GSIS, yung pag-ibig and yung tax para meron kayong rough estimation kung magkano yung sasahurin nyo. As for my case, almost the same lang din naman, nasa ganun din sa teacher 3 step 1 kasi konting-konti lang naman yung difference ng step 1 saka ng step 2 kasi step 2 pa lang naman ako. So, I hope that I have shared something. So, kung sakasakali na meron kayong question regarding the computation of your salary, I am always free to help you or just simply message me or paki-comment lang sa comment section kung gusto niyo ng assistance and I'll be willing to help you on computing your salary. So that's it. On my next video siguro I'll be sharing naman yung sa master teacher, sa head teacher and sa principal kasi medyo marami kaya pinagputol-putol ko yung mga videos and I might be computing as well for the salary of our public servants, yung ating mga nakaupo sa posisyon, yung mga mayors, vice mayor, president, vice president. So, naku-curious ako kung magkano na take home nila on a monthly basis. So, that's it. I hope I have shared something to you and please support me and watch my previous video. So, that's it. Thank you for watching.